So air is the another element, air, and we can understand that by moving. I mean, we only notice air when we see the leaves moving and things moving. Then we notice that there is air. We don't see it; it's not visible, but it's noticed by the movement. And so, any kind of motion in the nature, wind is the example. And because it is moving, so the things that are moving have to be lighter. The heavier they are, less moving. So, which means that air element has light quality, moving action. It's dry in nature because it's air, no, nothing to make it moist. So, dry in nature, it's dry. And it's rough. And it's cold because on its own it is cold, but because of movement, if it is coming from the hot area, then it will be hot, the wind will be hot. If it is coming from the cold region, then it is cold. So those are the properties, but basic quality of its own is the cold. So cold, dry, rough, light, moving, these are the things that air element has in the physiology. So because of the movement, so everything in the body that is moving, so we can think of the circulation, elimination, transportation of blood and transportation of nutrients and transportation of waste products out of the body, so all those kinds of things. And then the communication, so flow of thought, and then flow of sensation, sensory system, or motor system, blinking of eyes, pumping of heart, or any action, any minute action or big action, everything is basically due to air energy. So we can say moving energy, any subtle or big, like breathing, and also movement of intestines, pumping of heart, brain function. So all kinds of movements, subtle or more, they are all air element. Now air, because if it is heavy, then it will be more earthy, but because it is air, so that means it is fast moving, light. Those people who have more air element, they will be fast moving, light, thin body frame, tendency of underweight. They will struggle whole life to gain weight, and they will be quick in movement, speech, behavior, action, tend to have dry skin. And they will be very creative because thinking. So that's why they will become creative. Now, understanding air in the food, so if we compare it, these kinds of things will be more light, so which means very easy to digest, and they will be more porous. Like we can think like cornflakes, we can think of rice cakes, we can think of chips. If we think in terms of dairy, then it will be more goat milk or goat milk products. In the meat, if we think, so compared to beef, the chicken or fish, and even in the fish, the larger the fish means more earthy, and the smaller the fish means more airy. So the sardines, those would be, or shrimps, those would be more like air element examples of food. They will tend to create more, the airy food will tend to create more dryness in the body. And so if you have to balance and want to eat airy food, like say cornflakes or rice cakes, you have to put some ghee, some oiliness in it to balance out the dryness. Okay, so that's how we understand the air element in the nature, in the body, and also in the foods. The spices are the more the dry ones, dry spices that have less oiliness in them, and that have less aromatic oils in them. So like coriander is tend to be more dry compared to we can think of like clove. Or some example, like ginger. So ginger has more water content in it, so it's not as dry. And coriander would be more dry. Cumin is more dry. Turmeric is more dry. So these are more the dry type of spices. Okay?